Hello everyone, welcome to an Unreal Engine 5 tutorial on how you can import a font into Unreal to use for the text render. So in this example, I have two text render that I made, and it both uses two different fonts that I found on TechFont.com, which is the Good Brush and the TechFont. The process is pretty straightforward, so let's get right into it. To start, you will need to have a font file ready. So if you don't, I would recommend using my website called TheFont.com, which is this website. And in terms of fonts for the text render, I would suggest using a font that's not too fancy or stylized. So something like St. Carol will probably not work that well. And something like this one is, I think you'll run into a lot of issues if you try to use that. But if you want to try it out, feel free to do so. So for the purpose of this example, I'm just going to go to Cartoon. And for the font to download, there might be some licensing that you might want to take a look at, just to be sure. And most of the time, I'll just go search for 100% free and then update the search. So for these, for the example, I will just use Super Mario 256. So I'm just going to go ahead and make a download. And then you'll get a zip file. Once you have the zip file extracted, you will see that you have the TrueType font file, which is this one over here. And this is the file that we will need to import it into Unreal. But first, let's install this font into the computer first. Double click on it and then press install. And then it will install the font into the computer. After that, all you need to do is to drag the file into the Unreal folder that you're using. And it'll prompt up the import options, and all you need to do is go ahead and click on yes. With the file imported, you will see there are two new files that Unreal made. One is the font face and one is the font itself. We don't really need to do anything with the font face, so we can leave that as is. And what we need is to change the settings in the font. So let's open that up and you'll see this window. If you are using a font for widgets, you don't need to do anything at all. You can just leave it as it is. But if you want to use it for the text renderer, you will need to change the font cache type from runtime to offline. So let's click on that. And it'll prompt up this message, and all you need to do is click on yes as well. And from here, we will need to search for the font that we just installed onto the computer, which is Super Mario 256 right here, and I'll leave it as bold and make the size into somewhere around 28, I guess. Yeah, 28 work. Click on OK, and it'll change the window into this setting. So from here, we will need to change the distance field alpha and to check that up in order for it to work as the text renderer. And there are different settings here too as well. We can go around and play with. I'll go over some of the settings in a bit later, but let me just go ahead and finish explaining how you can set this up as a text render. So let's save this, and then what we need to do is we need to go on asset and then re-import the font into Unreal. So let's click on that, and it might take a while, so we just gotta wait until this runs and finish. And with that finished, you can see that the window changed into something like this. So now if we, let me just save all first. So now if we make a new text renderer, then go search in text render actor right here and drag this on to the screen. I'm gonna make it 0, 0, and I'm gonna scale this up. So here's the new text render, and you can see that there's a font over here in text material. We need to make a text material for our Super Mario text font. And to do that, I would just simply go ahead and copy and paste this default text material. So I'm gonna go browse it in the content folder and then duplicate it. And I'll rename this into Super Mario font. And then the next step is to drag this into the font folder that I have over here. Oh, Hold on, I didn't see. Let me save it first. And now I'll drag this into the font folder. And then with that in the font, I will open this up. And then what we need to do is simply we can change this font, which default is on the Roboto distance field. Let's change this into the Super Mario font. So click on the Super Mario font and click on this arrow, and then boom, it will be inside this material right here. And since I have these fonts glowing, I will just make a simple glow into the material. So let me do a multiply into the color. Put the emissive color and then change this into 20. So it'll have a glow when you put the texture on. Close it, and then I can change this text into the font that I want to use and change the material into the material that I just made. So there, boom. Now we have the Super Mario font into the text render. And I can change the text into the text prompt here, so let me just change it into "Thank you for watching." Yep, yeah, and there you go. We have this new font inside the Unreal Engine now. And I can also change the color if I want to do so. So there you go. And that's it. That's how you can import a font that you want to use into Unreal Engine. Just to give you guys a heads up, not all fonts will work with the text renderer. Here are four different fonts that I have as examples for what issues you may encounter when you use specific fonts. So in the first one, like this one, it's called Stasmic, this one over here. And you can see that the font itself is italicized. And when you have fonts that are italicized, you might run an issue where the words may be cut off like so. So as in, like, if we look at the I, like most of the I is gone, and the E, some parts of the E is gone, and the U and the Y. So I would suggest when you use fonts for text renderer, try to stay away from italicized fonts. And the second one, which is the one that I've used in the beginning, called the Good Brush. And if we were able to zoom in, you can see that there is some kind of brush texture in the text, the font itself. But in Unreal, you can see that the details are lost when you import it into Unreal to use for a text renderer. So just to give you guys a heads up, so some details may be lost in fonts that you may want to use. And for the third one, you can see that the font itself is, there's a lot of small artifacts and a lot of details are lost as well. And this font is called Frankfurt. So in Frankfurt, you can see that there's is kind of like a balloon-like font with these white areas. And you can see these white areas are kind of like broken apart. And for the last one, in terms of like more of a signature type of font, which I used a font called the Signature over here. So for this one, you can see that since the font is pretty thin, you will start seeing some wiggly lines in the font, and there are some details that are cut off, along with, because it's kind of italicized, so there are details and S that's, you can see that there's a straight line, straight cut off over here. So these are the issues that you may encounter. And to combat, you can kind of combat this with different settings in the font face, I mean in the font itself. So if you click on go into the font, you can change the settings of the width, texture page width, and increase the scale factor and change the radius of the radius scale of the font to kind of like make it better in a sense. And you can also change the height to a more bigger number, and then just save and then go to re-import the font itself. But then the issue is like if you increase these settings, it will take a lot more time to re-import, so you might have to wait for a while. And I have a different website you could do in the Unreal forums where it will tell you how to like combat the wiggly artifacts in your font. So I'll put this in the link below and in the description below so you guys can go and see what kind of settings you can do use to like change. And then the person who wrote this, DJ Midnar, gave a pretty nice detail of how you what you can do to change the parameters in the settings to make it look better. So there's that for you guys to check out. Yep, so these are the stuff that I want to share with you guys in terms of what issues you may have when you are trying to use fonts for the text render. And I hope you guys find this helpful. Good luck with the projects that you are working on. Thank you for watching. And as always, never stop learning.